You're watching Fox and Friends.
Welcome back to Fox and Friends. I'm Steve Ducey, and joining me as always, Gretchen Carlson and Brad Kilmeade.
Good morning.
Happy Monday.
Well, it's been 2 weeks and this Occupy Wall Street business keeps going.
Yeah.
And I, for one, still don't know what these people want.
I'll tell you what they need.
Uh-oh, look out.
Watch out, Gretchen!
A shower.
There she goes.
What really gets me mad is how people are now comparing Occupy Wall Street to the Tea Party.
Yeah, you know, it's apples and oranges.
It's night and day.
Yeah, just Batman and bananas.
I mean, it's nuts, okay? These protesters want anarchy. And, you know, all the Tea Party ever wanted was no government.
Isn't that anarchy?
No, anarchy is no government while people play bongos.
You know, and I gotta say, you young people have gotta be careful because it's so easy to get sucked into this crazy mob mentality.
Oh, so true, so true. I once thought I was following a crowd of people into Yankee Stadium, but it turns out I was in a breast cancer walk. When it was over, I was 10 miles from my car and I had to take a bus home.
All right, now get this. According to reports, the protests are costing the city of New York $1 trillion a day.
Wow.
Now that can't be right.
Well, that's what I heard.
Okay, well, when we have a question, we can always go to our fact checker, Lou. Ooh. Lou?
Ah, good old Lou, always keeping us honest. All right, moving on. We had a little incident this week on Fox and Friends.
Oh, did yeah. We?
It got weird.
We asked country music legend and voice of Monday Night Football, Hank Williams Jr., to come on our show, and let's say he got himself into a little bit of trouble.
Yeah.
Mr. Williams compared President Obama to Hitler, and we just don't say that on this show.
We imply it.
That's right. It's called manners?
Exactly. So here to explain himself is Hank Williams Jr.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Hey there, fellas. I know who's the friends and who's the fox. Looking good, Gretchen.
Hold up, Hank. Hold up. If I may speak for Mr. Williams.
Who are you?
I'm Chris Brooks, Mr. Williams' media representative. I'll be speaking for him from this point forward. Now, I understand you're upset, but you have to admit, you made a big mistake by letting Mr. Williams come on your show and speak for himself.
That's right.
I mean, what did you think he would say? Look at him. He looks like a truck stop Santa Claus.
Ho, ho, ho!
So this is our fault.
Well, you had a big role in it, and Mr. Williams would like an apology.
Hell yeah! Apologize to Bo Cephas!
Hank, stop. You're not helping.
Of course I'm not helping. I'm crazy.
You introduced Mr. Williams as a man who knew a thing or two about politics. Telling him he's a political analyst is akin to giving a baby a gun.
Hey, don't give a baby a gun. President Barack Hitler will just take it away.
Oh, man.
There
it
Hank.
There it is.
See, that's what Hank does. He calls everyone he doesn't like Hitler. He calls some of his friends Hitler.
Yeah, most of them are good guys, except for Travis. He's a real Hitler.
I'm sorry, I don't see how this is our problem.
Well, like I said, you let him talk. What Mr. Williams is good at is writing songs, like There's a Tear in My Beer, and sing-talking in front of cheerleaders for Monday Night Football.
Uh-huh.
Now, he wants to make this right, and he wrote a song to prove it.
Well, let's hear it.
You almost singing now?
Yes, now.
Are you ready for an apology? Well, you're not gonna get one, cause I calls them like I see them, and Obama's Hitler! And that's just...
Wow. Well, I think I speak for all of us when I say apology accepted.
Let's take a quick break, but first, our fact checkers have finished combing over the first 2 hours of the show, and we have a few corrections.
See you after this quick break.